Hello everyone! In this tutorial, we are going to be making a clone of the classic game Breakout. Now, for those of you too young to remember Breakout, I've loaded it up in Google Images here. It's basically a game that consists of lines of colored blocks, and you have to bounce a ball off them, and when the ball hits a block, the block vanishes and you earn points. So it's a very simple concept. Now, the first thing we need to do is, as usual, navigate to the Wade editor. So first of all, we need to go to www.clockworkchili.com. Once we get there, we just need to click Get Started Now. And of course, we're already watching a tutorial right now, so we just want to skip tutorials. No need to click on anything here. And we need a name for our project. Now, I don't want to call it Breakout. That's just copying it a bit too close. So instead, I'm going to call it Block Breaker. And we click Create Project. Now, this opens up our project in the Wade editor. It's currently just an empty scene. Nothing special here. And if I run it, it looks a bit boring. I mean, it's just black, not really interesting. So we need to import some assets. Now, I've already made the art assets for this game. They're fairly simple. I didn't spend too much time on them, but of course you can spend as much time as you want, make them more complex. And I've intentionally left a lot of blank areas and places for where you can improve the game and add your own things. So the first thing we need to do is set up the screen resolution. Now at the moment it's set from 00 to 1080p. I'm going to change this to 540 by 960 and I'm going to fix it at that resolution, just for simplicity's sake in this tutorial. And that's going to roughly be the size of a phone screen, and it's actually also the size of my background image. And if you're doing this, you probably want to match your background image to the higher resolution you use, the maximum size. So I'm going to drag in the background, and we just drag it from the bottom to the middle. I'm going to scroll the mouse wheel out just so I can get a better view. And we're going to go to properties. Now, the first thing we're going to do is rename this to background rather than scene object 1. We are going to set the position to 0 on both axes, so it is dead center in the middle of our screen. And we're just going to save our project. Now, if we run our project here, if I just go to run, we see the background just plain blue. Again, you can do something way more detailed. And I'm just keeping it simple for the tutorial. We'll just go ahead and close that. Now we also need to briefly go into sprites. And here we have our background sprite, the image. You can see the size there is indeed the same. And I'm going to set the layer to 10. Now this is just so when we add other images, we make sure that this background is behind everything else. Also, if the background is not on the same layer as anything else, given that it is never going to move, it is static, it doesn't have to be re-rendered to the canvas, so it's a lot faster if you keep big images, preferably on their own layer, providing they're not moving around at all. Okay, so we have a blue background. I think we need to add a title to this, so as I said, the game was called Block Breaker, and I mocked up a title earlier, which I'm just going to drag in here. There we go. Now, similar to background, we want to rename it, and I'm just going to name this title. Oops, make sure you're in the properties tab, not sprites. They are two different things. So I'm going to name this title. I'm going to set the X position to 0 and the Y position to -340. Yes, that works well. And I'm just going to click off that and save it. So if we run again, we now have our background image and our title. Of course, there's a lot of empty space here, and even after I add the next two things, there will still be empty space that you can use to add your own content. So this is a menu screen. I'm just going to add a few instructions on how to play the game, but I mean, very, very simple instructions, nothing complex. So rather than dragging an image, we want to add text. So I'm going to create a new scene object. You could actually do this as part of the background object if you want, but I'm not going to. I'm just going to do it as a separate object. And I'm going to call it instructions. The position of this is not important because we will be getting rid of this white sprite soon. So I go to the sprites tab. And I need to add a new text sprite. So I click this button. and then I click the minus sign here on the default white sprite to remove it. So now we have just an empty text sprite. I'm going to change the color of white by typing white. You can also use the color picker here, but for something simple, I would just type the color in. We're going to change the font size to 32 Arial. Of course, again, you can do something better than this, but I'm just keeping it simple for the tutorial's sake. And offset. Now, this is the offset of the sprite from the scene object location. This is going to be 0 for this one. We'll change it for the next. Layer 1, I'm actually going to put it to layer 5. And where is our offset? Sorry, not our offset. Our max width. There we go, here it is. I'm going to set the max width to 400. This just defines how wide the text can go before we start a new line. So the text for this is simply going to be move the mouse, and I'm just going to drag this over to the left a bit. Move the mouse to move the paddle. Fairly straightforward. And I'm going to add another text sprite to this. Here we go. And I'm just going to set it up pretty much the same way. 32 pixel Arial, color white, max width 400, layer 5, and we're going to change the Y value of the offset. This will just move it down, but I'm not going to do it yet because I want you to see what it looks like if we don't do this. Now, this instruction is simply going to be break blocks with the ball to earn points. Now, as you can see, it's writing it over the existing instructions, and that's why we need the offset value. So I'm just going to set this to 100. And yeah, I think that actually looks okay. So I'm just going to save this here, and I'm going to drag it so it's roughly in line with the B of block. Alignment is very important. And of course, again, if you're doing this and actually making your game, you would spend more time on getting it perfect, but I'm just doing it roughly for the tutorial's sake. So we save the project and we click run. Now we have a menu screen with a nice blue background, a title, and some basic instructions. Very nice. Now the next thing we need is a play button. Now this is going to leave a lot of empty space, but as I said before, you can add your own things to this. I'm just keeping it at the bare minimum for now. So we drag in a play button. We make sure we are on the properties tab. Set the position to 0, 300, I think, 300 on the y-axis. Actually, maybe a little bit lower. 320. Yeah, I like that better. We're just going to name this play button. And that's really all we need to do for now. This is pretty much our main menu done. Now, I've done this tutorial in parts, so part one is just making the main menu. And I think we'll also, just before we end this part, we'll create the new scene and we'll actually implement the functionality of the play button. So let's go ahead and do that. We need to create a new scene. Scene 1 is the menu. That's what we have. So we're going to right click down here, new file, and we are going to call this scene2.wsc. This is the scene that the game will run in. And I'm actually just going to swap over to that now just to set up something basic. It will prompt you if you want to save the current screen. Just click yes. So now we have a new scene, and we're just going to set up the basics before. I should say these don't actually have to match your menu screen, but it makes sense in this case. So we set up our resolution just like before. We drag our background image in. Of course, you could use a different background. I'm just using the same one. Position it 0, 0. Call it background, and everything is good. Now I'm just going to drag in a green tile, and I'm going to save this. So if we run this scene, sorry, we have, yes, this is scene 1 we're loading. I forgot, we initially load scene 1. We click on play, nothing happens. I'm just going to load scene 1 in the editor itself. So we need to select the play button, and we need to add an event handler. So we go to functions, and we want to scroll down to on mouse down. So basically when we click it, we want something to happen. Now we need to load a scene, and luckily app.js already does this for us. This is the file that runs when we first load our program. And you can see the first thing it does is it loads scene one. So all we have to do is copy this and paste it into on mouse down. Very, very simple. And we just need to rename this to scene2.wsc so it loads the second scene instead of the first. And I'm even going to put a console log in there just to say loaded game scene. Very straightforward. I'm going to save the project and run it. Here we have once again our menu. If I click play, we get scene 2. It loads the other scene, and this is what we see. So this is where we are going to make our game in part 2 of the tutorial. I just wanted to get this transition working right now. And also, if I go to the console logs by double-clicking down here, we see loaded game scene, so it definitely ran this code, even though it's fairly obvious it did. So thank you for watching part 1 of this tutorial, and hopefully you'll continue to part 2. See you shortly.